We're with Reto again, and we're going to see some basic chisel techniques from a master carver. So run us through the paces, Reto.
We do some Swiss Alps, a little modern style.
Okay.
We need not that much chisels. We use first a flat one, a number one.
Okay.
And one with an angle, number 14. For to do the details, number 11 and a number 2. For walls, it's a little bit more waved, the number 8. Also, we need a hand chisel, like this size. We do the valleys now.
I like the carving vise. Gets the work up to where you can use your body without bending, and that is nice.
It's important that you see always from the tool the angles. That when you go with the tool, with the angle into the wood, you see it cracks. You have the wood out of control. That's the reason why we do first the wellies, the Swiss mountain wellies. Okay, now we change, go to the number one. You see, the Swiss Alp comes out of this piece of wood.
Yeah, I think I see the Matterhorn there.
Yes, almost.
The Alps are the valleys, right?
Yes.
Of course.
You need valleys that you become Alps, or the Swiss mountains. And you have only to take this wood off what they are, the valleys.
Constantly reading the grain to get the right effect. Changing the angle to get the right cut so it doesn't tear out, but that you shear it off.
Yes. It's important when you think or when you feel and one side it cracks, you have to change. That's the right way. The wood goes like this way. And when you carve like this way, you think it's cracks, you have to change the side. You have to cut it off. Like here. You see, these are splitting now.
Yep.
You have to go from this side, to the backwards. That you have always a nice cut.
You're working with the grain.
And now we can do it without a hammer for to do finish stuff. To take some rest of wood for to take it out. And I take the tool in the back and with the hand, and I can give there a nice pressure. Okay, we change to the other one, number 11.
Now what you got going on right there?
You can do this a way up to the mountain.
Ah, it's a trail.
A trail. These are a tool also perfect for to do something to write. Number 11.
Okay, good. Oh, it's starting to look good, Reto. I think, is that Brienz down there?
Yes, this place is Brienz. After the other side is Lucerne.
Oh, perfect. He lives in Lucerne.
This one we can do a little bit flatter. Well, this goes more to Zurich. The other mountains come a little bit more flatter.
Okay. I can almost hear the yodeling in there.
Yeah.
Oh, that'd be the glacier coming down to the lake.
Yes.
Okay, I got you. Carvers. You have to have active imagination. Because seriously, one of the biggest things about carving is coming up with unique ideas to express yourself. Swiss made or file, and that's all you use because you really believe in the chisels and you can't find a better chisel. And by the way, Woodcraft just happens to be the only place that you can find Swiss made chisels, and that's been since 1968. So it's a good association.
And when you like to grow up to a big wood carver, you have to take these knives and chisels.
That's right.
Okay.
Looking good. Now there are some of the basic techniques. And you can see, he's not using force. It's a matter of using the angle of the chisel and the bevel, working with the grain, and also having the workpiece clamped high enough that you don't have to bend over as you're doing your work. So you have to step up to a good workbench, a good vise, excellent chisels, and keep them sharp. Reto, it is so much fun working with you. And people can find out more about Reto at his website, and there will be more information available on that, so look for that. Well, that about wraps it for today. We'll let you keep working away, and we really want to thank Swiss Made Chisel for getting you to come over here to Woodcraft in Parkersburg, West Virginia, and share your skills with us. It's just outstanding.
I change to carve in hand. It's important that you have the chisel in both hands.
The quality of those cuts is staggering. The wood just glows. And that's what you get from a sharp chisel. Now, you need to show us how you can use
We have
detail.
One more for detail.
And I find the knife he has in his hand right now is the most useful carving knife in my collection. For the fine detail work, you just cannot beat it. Okay, well, folks, Reto and Lucerne, Switzerland?
Yes, I'm staying at Stans next to Lucerne.
Okay, and that's where your studio is?
Yes.
Okay, and of course, if anyone needs a carving, you are for hire.
Yes, sure.
You do take commission work. Well, there you have it from the folks from Woodcraft Supply and from Swiss Made of file chisels. A great combination.